So I'm going to come back to the same question, where the question was being asked if a Muslim can marry a Muslim to the non-Muslim, like Jewish, Christian, and anybody else. Well, if we come to the same conditions in order to marry someone, someone believes that there is only one God, who is alone power, who is alone sustainer, alone doer for everything, and there is no other power except the one Allah. He is a pure Muslim and his Aqidah is pure. Now coming to the seed, that is something different. But when it comes to the Aqidah, if someone believes that Allah is one, and he's a soul doer and the soul of power of everything, and his life totally rely on Allah, he's a Muslim. Now the second step is he or she has to believe the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the last messenger. If someone believes that, and he or she also believes that the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the messenger of Allah, and David alaihi wasallam was the messenger of Allah, and Jesus peace be upon him was also messenger of Allah, and he or she believes that the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came at the last, who came like more than 1400 years ago with the final revelation of God, which was the Holy Quran. Someone believes in that, he is a pure Muslim. So now if someone believes that, so if someone is born in a Jewish family and someone born in a Christian family or any family, but someone believes on this particular karma, he is a Muslim, and yes, you are allowed to marry. But if someone contradicts that, believing that if someone is a Christian, if someone believes that Jesus, peace be upon him, have some type, now those of some of the people, if someone believes to, for an example, like a Jesus, peace be upon him, to be a God, and believes him also as a son of a God, and also believes in the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be the last messenger, so that person is not a Muslim, because he or she is putting everything together in a one basket. So he or she has to filter out, like Allah is one, and he or she has to filter out that the Jesus, peace be upon him, was a messenger of God, and after that the last messenger who came after about like 600 years later was the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who came after approximately 600 years after, and he came with the final revelation was the with the Quran. So that person is a Muslim. So if you put everything together in one basket, that person is a not Muslim. And there's a beautiful ayah in the Holy Quran in Surah Baqarah, verse number 208, where Allah says, "Ya ayyuhallazina amanu udkhulu fis-silmi kafatan ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان انه لكم عدو مبين." Like, all you who believe, put yourself entirely into Islam and do not give the chance to a shaitan to come to you and try to remove you from the straight path. That's like udkhulu fi silmi kaffatin. Put yourself into the Islam and stay on the straight path and do not contradict La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. So that particular person is being called Muslim.